Michael J. And today I wanted to talk to you about Disney. It was back when Frozen opened. I went to a matinee and I saw Frozen. And then I came home and I was thinking about it a lot. And I thought I was in a Disney mood because I had been to see Frozen. And I flipped through what I had in my video collection and decided to pull out Pinocchio. And I put Pinocchio in while I was eating dinner. And I realized, I knew this before, but it came back to me how brilliant that movie is. And I started thinking about some of the other movies made while Walt Disney was alive as the producer and had his hand firmly in the film. And they're really amazing. I guess I don't have to say that, everybody knows that. But then I started to think about Frozen and was disappointed in it because, for me, it doesn't really live up to the artistry of those old films, and I wish somehow they would reclaim those days and get back to making something as really wonderful as Pinocchio or Bambi, and even Snow White. Snow White, one thing about a scene in Snow White, and I'm going to show this to you, the scene where the witch or the queen transforms into the old hag is amazing because you have to understand there's no computers involved. Right now that effect would be done with computers, and this has a depth to it. And it looks like the camera is moving around her, and well, the fact is that the room's spinning around her, and the 3D-ness of it is so vibrant, more so than the 3D I was witnessing at Frozen. And then there are cases in Pinocchio that are like this. The use of the invention of the multi-plane camera, which started in a short subject of Silly Symphony about the old mill, and then was used in Snow White and really used in Pinocchio to great effect. But besides that real sense of depth you get, and it's better than putting on 3D glasses. It's really amazing. I'm going to show you some of these scenes. There's a wonderful moment in Peter Pan where they fly over the clouds and you really see London way down there. That it's amazing, and there's no 3D glasses out. What's amazing to me is the hand-drawn aspect of, say, a moment in Pinocchio, when Pinocchio realizes he's a real boy. A, there's the kid playing the voice, who does a great job, and then there is the animator who hand drew with just a few lines, really, it's a simple character, this realization that comes over his face when he sees his hand and realizes he's a real boy. You just see it come over him. I mean, it's an acting moment that if you caught that little boy with actual photography on the live actor doing that and you had that moment, you'd be pleased as punch that you captured that moment for your movie. But here it is hand-drawn on paper and then transferred to plastic and painted frame by frame, and they get it and it matches the voice perfectly. It's an amazing little moment of acting in that movie. There's other parts of that movie that are like Hitchcock came on board to help direct it, because you get these film noir shadows, and the sequence where Lampwick turns into a donkey is like a horror movie, and it's so effective. And there's so many, and I won't even go into all of them, but that kind of filmmaking, and I'm going to tell you that Pinocchio it stands up against any movie, live action or not, who cares that it's animated. It's just a fantastic movie. And it's a musical and has a good score. It's like a musical meets adventure movie, in animation, all smooshed together. But it is as real of a major achievement as anything that was being done at that point. And it's, you know, one of my top 10 favorite movies of all time. But let's take a look at this moment from Snow White that I think is amazing. All because it's hand-drawn. Here we go.
Now, begin thy magic spell.
Hands.
My voice. A perfect disguise.
No. This is one of the most powerful movie sequences ever, animation or not. Look at the detail in this sequence. Watch how Prince Philip moves and reacts. He's so lifelike.
Me, oh Prince, and all the powers of hell!
Notice the lighting and camera angles. Okay, now here's that Hitchcockian sequence in Pinocchio.
Did that come out of me? Oh. Huh? What the? What's going on? Oh! I've been double-crossed! Help! Help! Somebody help! I've been framed! Help! Please, you gotta help me! Pinocchio is voiced by a young actor named Dickie Moore. He was a really hardworking actor at this time in Hollywood. Here he is in Mr. Smith Goes to Washington.
To the headwaters of a stream known as Willet Creek.
Here's that wonderful marriage of animator and voice actor.
Father, what you crying for?
Because you're dead, Pinocchio.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. Now lie down.
But, Father, I'm alive, see? And I'm real.
Isn't that wonderful? And now here's a stunning moment from Bambi. It's devastating emotionally, and it's absolutely gorgeous visually.
Now here's an example of the brilliance of the multiplane camera and that depth you can really get with it. And mind you, this is all hand-painted stuff, but that forest just looks really deep. It's amazing. And now here's my favorite little sequence of Peter Pan. It's that really stunning flying moment going over the top of London.
There it is, Wendy. Second star to the right and straight on till morning.
When there's a smile in your heart, there's no better time to start.
Think of all the joy you'll find when you leave the world behind.
And bid your cares goodbye.
Okay, because it's Christmas time in December, I leave you with this moment from the Nutcracker Suite, this beautifully animated sequence from Fantasia.
Yeah.